I'm Nigam Shah. I'm an assistant professor of medicine at Stanford University. So I grew up in India, and I spent some part of my childhood in Africa. And in both circumstances, in both those situations, I grew up in pretty much small towns. My father was a surgeon. My mother was a principal of the local school. We pretty much knew everybody in the town. So it was a very close-knit community. Growing up, I was pretty into anything related to science. We used to build model rockets. We actually built a device that would take pulp and make paper out of it. I came in to this country just as an experiment, trying to figure out, do I like research or not? And I just got hooked into the notion of using computers to understand things in medicine, and then never looked back. So in our group, we study how to understand better care using lots of electronic medical records. But the idea is to enable the experiences of similar patients inform your care. I mean, you wouldn't think twice about your doctor looking up 1,000 people who are just like you and based on that say, you know, this worked in about 80% of them, so that's what we're going to try. We're 16 people trying to push in the same direction. So everybody has their own independent projects, but at the same time, helping other people on their projects so that in exchange, you can ask for their help on your projects. Different people look at the same thing and they might have a slightly different interpretation, which might not be the same as yours. And the most important thing to remember is that if people spend 2-3 years with you, doing research with you, it is sort of your responsibility and your job to make sure that they get to where they want to get or they're trying to get. You can think of a project as something that one person does and writes a scientific paper about. Or you can think of a project in terms of all of the different mini experiments you do, some of which lead to a paper, some of which don't, in order to answer a broad question.
We got this really cool result the other day where we were looking at the cartilage, and I was wondering if you thought that, can think of any ways to try to bring in more vasculature?
I have no idea.
Not everything you start leads to success. Not every project leads to a publication. It's not wrong to fail, and at least if you haven't failed even once, it means you're not trying hard enough. But when you fail, you have to step back and understand why you failed so that you don't make those same mistakes again. Medical research is, I would say, at one of the most exciting moments. I mean, for the first time, medicine as a whole can ask questions about disease and response to disease and response to treatment using large amounts of data instead of small samples of 1,000 people or 500 people. Well, the most important thing about getting into medicine these days is to learn math. It's kind of surprising, but this science, this field is becoming extremely quantitative and data-driven. Just like a few centuries ago, learning how to write was a luxury. And then it basically became a necessity no matter what you wanted to do. Whether you're an English major or a science major or what have you, you still learn how to write. Writing code, writing a computer program, is going to become like that, or I would say it has even become that today. You cannot afford to drop your computer science, your statistics, your engineering, typically called the STEM classes. And then after that, once you've got the basic skills, follow the question that interests you. You don't have to, you know, study yeast if you don't want to. You don't have to study mice if you don't want to. The field is much broader than what you would find based on a few examples in your textbook. So talk to your science teachers, go to the local university, try to rotate in labs that do actual research, spend summers getting your hands dirty doing research, and then make a decision, what is it that you like or not like. I think the most important characteristic is to be comfortable in the presence of uncertainty, to be humble about what you don't know, and not give up.